we're asked to add and simplify. And we have the principal root of 2x squared plus 4 times the principal of root of 8 plus 3 times the principal root of 2x squared plus the principal root of 8. So we could do a little bit of adding. We could actually simplify first and then add, or we could add first and then simplify. But it looks like we can already add, so let's try to do that. So here, right over here, I have a principal root of 2x squared. And over here, I have three principal roots of 2x squared. Well, if I have one of something here, and I have three of something here, and I need to add them together, I could put a 1 coefficient out here to make it clear. This is one of this thing, and I have three of these things. Well, if I have one of this thing and three more of these things, and I add them together, I'm going to have four of those things. So this is 4 times the principal root of 4 times the principal root of 2x squared. If that confuses a little bit, imagine this whole principal root of 2x squared was some variable. Let's say that this whole thing was a. And let's say that this whole thing was a as well, because it's the same thing. Then you'd have 1a plus 3a's, which would give you 4a's. In this case, a is all of this business right over here. So we added those terms, and then we want to think about, we have 4 principal roots of 8. And we have one more principal roots of 8. So same idea. You have 4 of these things that I'm circling in magenta. And then you have one more of these things that I'm circling in magenta. That one coefficient is implicit. So if I have 4 of something plus one more of something, it becomes 5 of that something. So plus 5 times the square root plus 5 times the square root of 8. And now let's see if we can simplify this anymore. We have 4 of something, and then we have 5 of something else, so you can't just add these two things together, but maybe we can simplify this a little bit. So we know that the principal root of 2x squared, this is the same thing as, so let me write the 4 out front. So we have the 4, and the principal root of 2x squared is the same thing as the principal root of 2 times the principal root of x squared. So I just rewrote this part right over here. And then we have plus 5 times, now 8 can be written as a product of a perfect square and a not so perfect square. 8 can be written as 4 times 2. So let's write it that way. So if we view this whole, this is the principal root, the square root of 4 times 2, we can rewrite this as 5 times the square root of 4, or the principal root of 4, times the principal root of 2. And what can we simplify here? Well, we know what the principal root of x squared is. It is the positive square root of x squared. So it's not just x. You might be tempted to just say it is x. But since we know that it is the positive square root, we have to say it's the absolute value of x. Because what if x was negative? If x was negative, you'd have let's say it's negative 3. You'd have negative 3 squared, you'd have a positive 9. And so the principal root of a positive 9 is going to be a positive 3. And so it wouldn't just be x. It wouldn't be negative 3. It would be positive 3. So you have to take the absolute value. And the other thing that's a perfect square is this 4 right here. Its principal root is 2. Its principal square root, I should say, is 2. So now you have, if we just change the order that we're multiplying right here, you have 4 times the absolute value of x, 4 times the absolute value of x times the square root of 2, times the square root of 2, I want to do that in that same yellow color, times the square root of 2, plus we have 5 times 2, which is 10. Right? This whole thing simplified to 2. So we have plus 10 square roots of 2. Now, we could call it a day and say that we're all done adding and simplifying. Or you could add a little bit more depending on how you want to view it. Because over here, you have 4 times the absolute value of x square roots of 2. And here you have 10 square roots of 2. So you have 4 absolute value of x of something, and then you have 10 of that same something. You could add them up. Or another way to think about it is you could factor out a square root of 2. Either one of those works. And so you get 4 times the absolute value of x plus 10 times the principal square root of 2. So depending on whether you view this or this more simplified, one of those two will satisfy you.